In this screencast, we talk about energy balances and the differences between closed and open systems. A closed system is one where mass does not cross the boundary between the system and the surroundings. In an open system, mass will cross the boundaries. However, in both of these systems, energy crosses the boundary between the system and the surroundings. So let's start with the governing equation for a closed system. Delta U, which is the change in internal energy, plus delta E sub P, which is the change in potential energy, plus delta E sub K, which is the change in kinetic energy, equals Q, which is heat, minus W, which is work. The first thing we do with this equation is to simplify it. If there's no acceleration of the system, then we can say that there is no change in kinetic energy. If there's no change in height of the system, then we can say that the change in potential energy is zero. If the temperature of the system equals the temperature of the surroundings, or the system is perfectly insulated, then Q equals zero. And the term we often use to describe this is that the system is adiabatic. If there are no moving parts or electric currents or radiation at the boundary, then W equals zero. The governing equation for an open system is almost the exact same equation with two important differences. The first one is that we have this delta H instead of delta U, and delta H is the change in enthalpy. And secondly, there is flow in the system. So these are per unit time. And again, we have the same kind of simplifications as we did in the closed system. One important thing to note here is that the change in energy, such as delta H, delta U, etc., is the difference between the final enthalpy and the initial enthalpy. This is the difference between the final and initial state of the system. However, with Q and W, this depends on what happens across the boundary between the system and the surroundings. Why don't we look at an example? If we have a cylinder with a movable piston, which moves slowly to compress a gas, we can neglect the potential energy. What is the energy balance? First of all, is this a closed system? Yes, there's no mass escaping, and the initial and final states are stationary. Now, let's say that this is carried out instead isothermally. If that's the case, then delta U will equal zero, and we're left with that Q equals W. Finally, let's say that our system is adiabatic, and again, we're going to neglect our potential energy. What we're left with is that delta U equals negative W. Now, let's look at an example of an open system. Here we have a liquid stream that flows through a heat exchanger where it's heated, and we know that the inlet and outlet pipes have the same diameter and that there is no change in elevation. Let's look here If the inlet and outlet pipes have the same diameter, then there is no change in velocity. Note that we said that it was a liquid stream, which implies that density is constant. Here, there is no change in elevation, so between those two, we know that the potential energy, or the change in potential energy, as well as the change in kinetic energy, equals zero. In addition, we have no moving parts, no shaft work, so what we're left with is that Q equals delta H. Now let's say that this stream is pumped through a pipe. What would the balance be? Now we do have work, so Q minus W equals delta H. Finally, let's say that the system is insulated, there are no moving parts, the potential and kinetic energy are negligible, so what we're left with is that delta H equals zero. And so what that really means is that the initial enthalpy is equal to the final enthalpy. Generally, when you do an energy balance problem, you need to start with using the proper form of the energy balance, closed or open, and then look at the problem itself and decide what terms can be dropped to simplify your equation.